guys, it's Denma. Welcome to the Wolf's Den, and today I'm doing a very tiny, tiny, minuscule Amazon haul. I went and primed a few things a couple nights ago. Well, actually, it was Friday night. I got them yesterday, and I'd like to share them with you, if that's okay. I've already opened the boxes, so that way I can make sure the merchandise is in there. The first thing I got, because I'm a Twilight whore at heart, is this Twilight Bella. After she's become a vampire party. I want to get the regular Bella too, but she was still pretty expensive. This one was only $9. And look at it, it's collector's. I mean, there's no dents or anything in the pack. They're not awesome. I had also ordered Monster High dolls since I heard Monster High has been discontinued. So I was looking on the Monster High checklist website of all the dolls that I didn't have and seeing which ones I might want. And that's what I really went on to Amazon and eBay for. I had ordered one set of Claudine because the Wolf family is my favorite. So it was Claudine Wolf and Claude Wolf. And it was like they were in some sports outfits of the two-pack. And I had actually ordered that too, but it had one left. And when I placed my order, everything was fine. And all of a sudden I get a note from Amazon saying, dude, blah, 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 blah. You do not have this item in stock anymore. And they refunded me. So yeah, that sucks, but it's on eBay still, so, and I don't mind getting them loose because I don't care about the packaging, because usually I take them out and pose them when I have space to pose them. Right now all my loose ones are in a couple of Rubbermaid containers, and I have 4 or 5 Rubbermaid containers full of Descendants, Monster High, Super DC Superhero Girls dolls, Ever After High dolls. Because Ever After High was discontinued, I think last year, the year before that, they kind of brought this little line of Enchantimals in. It was the one that came out of that order. So I placed 2 different orders on the same day. Because I was going back and forth, so I was like, well. But yeah, she's really pretty. She actually kind of does look like Bella. I mean, she had the traditional Barbie face, but the outfit and everything and the hair and the eye color change looks like Vampire Bella, because I have the Triss doll from Divergent. And I've seen the 4 doll, and those look nothing like their characters. The only thing that is even close is the outfit. So I never happened to get the Triss doll for $5 at Kmart because they were going out of business. That's the only reason why I got it. It was cheap. And late last year, early this year, Museum PC was cleaning out the TARDIS and stuff, getting it ready for me to come home from the hospital and stuff, and he put some of my books up on this rack above the toilet, and it's an RV, so you have to put the stuff in the toilet so it'll dissolve everything and go through and not clog up. TMI, I know, but still. So that had accidentally tipped onto some of my books, which was okay, but one of them was from indie publisher. I didn't know they still had it, and I was in the process of reading it. And it was, when I found it, it was swollen up and the pages were still wet and soggy, and I'm just like, throw that out. But luckily, they still had it on Amazon. It is Hook's Little Mermaid. Bam. Because I ship Hook and Ariel from Once Upon a Time. I think they should have been something, at least a fling in the past. Even with the finale, Wish Hook said that Ariel was one of his close friends, actually got him to stop drinking and change his path that he was on. I'm like, why not date those two together? That you're just, I don't like Emma and Hook. That's your ship, that's fine, but it was forced down our throats like every episode, every season, once they finally became an item. And I was just like, I'm sick of it. But anyway, I got that, and when I was there picking this up, I found they had book 2 of Red's Tangled Tale. These are not, they have all the fairy tale characters in them, like Once Upon a Time does, but they're not your typical. Like, they have Tinkerbell in this one, I know, and Red Riding Hood. I call her Red or Ruby from Once Upon a Time just by default. But she's in this one, and I hadn't finished it yet, but she's not your typical Red Riding Hood. And I really like these type of books that are indie published and are self-published, and they're like new takes on fairy tales. So if you know of any, put them down below, because I would love to read them. I have a ton on my Kindle. I have like 3,000 books on my Kindle, but at least they don't take up space like real books do. But nothing beats like opening up a page of a book, like a real book. And plus you want to support authors as much as you want, or as much as you can, because it takes a lot to print a book. I mean, you have to commission the cover and get them to do all the text work, unless you're good at graphic design. Then you have to find a publisher that wants to print your book, or is interested in printing your book. And if you can't, you can print it on your own. I think Doolulu and a couple other places. But usually that can be pricey, especially if you don't have a thicker book. I know I was looking at into publishing a book, self-publishing. I just wanted one copy for me. It was about a different type of werewolf that nobody's ever heard of before or seen, like the abilities that they have. But the pocket size, which is... If you get your book printed, this is a really, really old book, this size, like your typical, I don't know what they call it, but it's called pocket size on Lulu. This is the cheapest format, and depending on how you think you want your pages, how big you want your print, plus you have to go through and format it to their, they have templates you can download, so that's nice, but it takes a lot of work for one person to get their book published. Unless they just have that magical Harry Potter, Twilight, Percy Jackson, Let Me Sneak It, Hunger Games effect, Divergent, all that stuff. So I got these two. The one to replace the old one and then the new one. So, out from that. And the last item I got, I've been looking for quite a while, hoping I would find it in stores, but I haven't. Because it's from 2015. It's another Barbie, but it's actually a Barbie Barbie. But this is how she came. She's from 2015. I didn't do that. So whoever packages this was not a fulfillment by Amazon, a third party seller. They had the right cardboard insert, but this isn't the right plastic top because this is supposed to fit in like that. And you see it's where it's embossed, it's supposed to form around them and it doesn't. It's still a fashionista's like case, but I wanted this as a collector's item. So I had to contact Amazon and they initially refunded me on the Bella doll because I hadn't gotten the Bella doll yet. I'm like, refunded me for the wrong doll, and this one was $20. There's like a $10 price difference. And they're like, okay, we'll send you the rest of the refund, which they did, and they were super sweet about it. The reason I wanted her is she's petite, and you know, she looks like Taylor Swift. I've always wanted this doll ever since I saw it. I've been looking for number 23, and I've got 33. And my first one was 27. This one, she was the first curvy doll, and she had blue hair. At the time, I had blue hair, and she was like, twinsies. But this one has like almost like cowboy type boots, the red skirt, the bob. I think it's Taylor. Where have you been anyway? But anyway, that was it. Like, comment down below if you have like said any of the books, like if you know of any book that's kind of like a twisted take on a fairy tale. It doesn't have to be like horror or anything, just a different take on a fairy tale. They were pretty popular a couple of years ago, especially once Twilight came out, like 2008 or 2005, something like that. They were like coming out from big publishers so much. But yeah, put those below, subscribe, join the pack because we'd love to have you here, and we'll see you next time. Until then, bye guys.